Let's all play What's My Line? And now, let's meet this week's What's My Line panel. First, TV comedian, romantic symbol of masculinity, on whom no gal has been able to pin anything on him since he was 3 months old. Soupy Sales!
They weren't able to pin anything on me? Do you know that we were so poor my mother couldn't afford talcum powder when I was born? For about 3 months, I had to rough it. Here's another one you won't care for. No, I won't. We'll get on with the game here. But right now, here's somebody you will care for because they care for every night, honey. There she is, stumbling out here right now, dancing her way into your hearts. Would you say hello to Melba Tolliver?
Thank you for that clumsy introduction.
Yeah, right.
Now, won't you say hello to the fake brick maker from Cape Cod, Gene Rayburn?
Would you just explain that, please?
I won't explain you.
Well, what she's talking about, I have a factory that makes plastic bricks. And it's beautiful. It's called Brickover. That's a little plug. Now, let's give a big warm welcome and a grand plug for a grand lady. Here's Arlene Francis.
Now, here's a gentleman who can build almost anything with his hands. And he's very good with his head, too. Wally Bruner.
Thank you, Arlene, and welcome everyone to What's My Line.
Thank you.
What have you been doing, Gene? You've been building masonry homes or what?
Well, we use our fake bricks inside and outside, and they work very well. You'd swear it was a real brick wall. After
I know. I saw one of these walls, and I swore at it.
All right. But now let's meet our first challenger. So will you enter and sign in, please?
Carol Ison.
And Miss Ison, where are you from?
New York City.
All right, panel. Carol Ison has written a most amusing book about a very commonplace human activity. Let's show the audience just what the subject of her book is. So the subject of her book is a very commonplace human activity. And we'll begin with Jean.
Yes, sir. Thank you, Wally. Miss Ison, this commonplace human activity, can we assume that...
what? Your first line is so funny.
Can we assume that it can only be engaged in by women?
No.
Oh. One down, Arlene.
Is it something, this activity, that one does to oneself?
No.
Two down, Soupy.
Is it an activity that takes a person around the world or in a country somewhere?
No.
Three down, Melba.
Is it an activity that one engages in every day?
Yes, generally speaking.
Unfortunately.
Yeah, right, yes.
Unfortunately, huh? Do you perform or do this activity at home?
Yes.
Always? Not always. I take that question back. Would it be strange if you did this someplace outside your home?
Yeah, I think so.
I think this is something that...
Isn't an activity that is usually engaged in a particular room of your home?
No.
Four down, Gene.
That would rule out things like snoring and stuff like that.
Sleeping.
Sleeping, yeah, and all those things have to do with a particular room. Let's see. Is this Are there physical props of any kind involved in this activity?
Yes.
All sorts of them.
Really? Well, now let's see. Does it have anything to do with clothing the body or covering the body in any way?
No.
I don't think so. Five down, Arlene.
Does it have something to do with housekeeping?
Yes.
In fact, that's it.
What?
How about with housekeeping?
Housekeeping.
But Carol is the author of the book Nobody Said You Had to Eat Off the Floor, The Psychiatrist's Wife's Guide to Housekeeping. And this is
a copy of the book right here.
It's published by McKay. Nobody Said You Had to Eat Off the Floor, The Psychiatrist's Wife's Guide to Housekeeping. I don't know. Do you have to be a psychiatrist's wife to write something like this, Carol?
Well, you certainly don't have to be a psychiatrist's wife to do housework.
I understand you love housework.
Oh, no, you understand totally incorrectly.
You don't care for it?
Not in the least.
She said through gritted teeth.
Do you have a basic philosophy about housekeeping?
Oh, I think if there's anything basic, it's that generally the junk in your head is the cause of the mess on your floor and vice versa.
Well, what gave you the idea to write a funny book about it?
Well, I started out writing a very straight book on housekeeping, and I was agonizing over getting it written, and I couldn't get it done, and I started thinking how it was as hard to write a book as it was to clean a floor, and somehow this came of it.
Hmm. And what does your husband think of it?
He thinks it's sort of fun. He's pretty generally pleased.
Does he do any of the housekeeping?
Yes, when he's forced.
Do you have a maid?
I have somebody who's sort of, kind of...
Does the windows?
No. I had somebody coming up, you know, to wash those. Nobody would hang out a 7th-floor window, I don't think.
Well, you know, it's become a tradition on What's My Line, Carol, to test our panel's skill or lack of it into various activities and occupations which come before it. Right, panel?
Yes.
This time we've prepared a rather diabolical test of the panel's housekeeping abilities, and right now I think enough has been said staggeringly and stutteringly so Lloyd, open the curtains. Now, panel, one of those very ordinary chores that we do around the house is make bed, right? Very simple. So we're going to divide the panel into two teams, Melba and Soupy in one team, Jean and Arlene in the other. Would you join me now,
please? All right, let's go.
Now, the object of this game is, of course, that each team has a pair of beds. Come right on over here, Jean.
Okay.
Let's get this thing explained. There are two beds for you and Arlene, two beds for
two
Melba
beds
and
for
Soupy.
Is
the continental breakfast included?
Now, if you will notice closely, there are pillows and pillow slips and two sheets and a blanket for each bed. So you must get all the pieces put together and on
your
the bed. It's going to be a bit of a contest. Speed is important, but so is neatness. Ready, set, go!
Get in there, get in there. That's it.
Ready? Done.
All right.
Now you have to tuck anything in.
Tuck everything in. I saw you.
Are you going to do which one are you going to do?
Up where the...
All right. There's
no sheets.
Somebody
glued the sheets together.
Sticky sheets. That's not fair.
Hey, it's the Jolly Blue Marshmallow.
Did you get the sheets?
Melba, you can get put in jail for keeping a disorderly house. Come on now. Let's go. Come on, Melba. The meeting is at 8 o'clock tonight.
Do we have a winner?
I think we'll have to declare it a tie. I certainly nobody's ever had so much fun doing it.
All right, and as a prize, since it is a tie, your husband has consented to see all four of them. Is that correct?
Absolutely.
After making beds like that, I think it's very necessary. Carol, thank you so much. It was a pleasure meeting you on What's My Line. And that's my line.
and we'll continue right after this one.
Well, good group, that was well done. You're all good bed makers.
Yeah, but who makes beds that have to make beds that fast?
Yeah.
You know, you gotta go and make a bed, you have a cup of coffee, you talk on the phone, you tuck in a little bit, take a nap, you know, wave out the window.
Really?
And, yeah, not like that. Who rushes around that? If you rush around that fast, you belong to a psychiatrist.
All right, well, let's see what happens, like though, that. With our next challenger. So will you enter now and sign in, please? Mike McCaslin. And Mike, where are you from?
I'm from Monterey Park, California.
All right, panel, Mike McCaslin is president of the student body at the Mark Keppel High School in Alhambra, California. Now, he also happens to be the world's record holder at eating something. As a matter of fact, he ate 255 of these things in 45 minutes.
That's what was that now?
He ate 255 of these things in 45 minutes. Now let's show the audience what he is, the world's champion at eating.
255.
And we'll begin with Melba.
I'll bet what you eat is something that's really not all that pleasant, right? is it a vegetable?
Well, no, that's a...
Okay. Is it something that's in the vegetable line?
Yes.
Pickles?
Well, wait just a moment. It is not a vegetable.
No, so he's not the champion pickle.
So it's one down. Gene.
Now, how come there's a little disagreement there? He said, yes, it's a vegetable, and you said no. Who's the guest here?
I run the show.
Who's the head of the house? Yeah.
Said, definitely not a vegetable.
It is not a vegetable.
Was it ever a vegetable? I mean, can we assume it was never a vegetable, right?
No.
It's not transformed.
You may assume that.
No. Yes. All right, well then, can we assume that this thing grew on land?
Yes.
All right. Is it in the insect family?
No. Two down, Arlene.
Well, he could be an anteater for me.
Since there was some sort of a nervous discussion about vegetable, is it possible that it was a fruit?
Yes.
Uh-huh. Now, those things that we think are vegetables and are... and our fruits are things such as tomatoes,
right.
Nuts.
Atta girl.
Anybody?
Now, how many no's do you want?
No, I'm thinking it's out loud. Did you eat 255 nuts?
No. Three down, Soupy.
I just had a wild idea that every time we would ask Mike a question, he wouldn't talk, he'd belch. You know, because you eat that much of something, you know. Does this thing have a skin on it?
Yes.
Is it ever come in bright colors?
No. Four down, Melba.
It never comes in bright colors?
No. What'd you have in mind, Soupy?
Banana.
Oh. Okay, Melba, go ahead.
Is it a fruit that can be held in your hand?
Yes.
Oh, he's a watermelon.
255 of them?
Do they come in bunches?
Yes. Well, no. They do not come in bunches. Five down, Gene.
Well,
are
we talking about something?
Are you talking about the same thing?
I don't think it's such
our time is almost
cherries.
Up.
Are we talking about cherries?
No.
No, that's a fruit.
I'm flipping all the cards and declaring Mike a winner and telling you that he ate, in 45 minutes, 255 prunes. But Mike is the world's prune eating champion.
Were they pitted?
or did wrinkled?
Were they pitted, or did you pit them out?
After I ate them, I took the pits
you
out of my
took
mouth.
Took the pits out.
He pit them out after he ate.
Did you after each one, or do you wait till you get a bunch of pits?
No, I did it one at a time.
Mike, what was the previous record?
154, and that was by a boy from England.
Did you miss school a lot after that?
No, the problem was they wouldn't let me in school after that. Well, how are the prunes prepared? The prunes were prepared, that they were soaked overnight, so they got puffy with a lot of water in them. That was that was in the record book, that it'd be like that.
Are you in the record book, the official, with all the Olympic
stars? Oh, the Guinness
Book
of Records.
Yes, yeah. But is that a category in the Guinness Book of Records? I mean, is that, are you listed
Well, let
there?
Me tell you about it. I understand the editors of the Guinness Book of Records have stopped publishing records for eating things on the grounds that too many people were getting sick trying to break the records. And I have to ask you, Mike, did you have any trouble along that line?
No, you see,
never mind.
I have been training. I have been training for it, so I was expecting everything.
How do you train for it?
You eat a lot of rice. That's how you train for it.
Well, you know, panel, Mike's record of 255 prunes in 45 minutes amounts to about 5.5 prunes a minute.
Oh,
now, panel, you think you can do as well?
No.
5.5 prunes a minute. No.
Well, don't worry. We're not going to ask you to drive, but we are going to say, Mike, thank you so much for joining us on What's Next.
Now, panel, once again, we've reached that very special part of What's My Line, the time we meet our mystery guest. I see the blindfolds are in place, so, mystery challenger, will you enter and sign in, please? All right, panel, as you know, it is indeed one question at a time. We'll give you 2 minutes to try and establish the identity of our mystery guest, and we'll begin with Soupy.
Thank you, Wally. Mystery guest, that was a wonderful ovation. Is that because we'd recognize you from your many appearances on television?
Perhaps. Most definitely. Melba.
Mystery guest, are you associated with a program that's regularly on television, a weekly series of some kind?
Yes, but not weekly.
Gene. That's something like First Tuesday. Third Monday. I'll meet you on every other odd Friday. Well, let's see. Are you an actor?
No.
Arlene.
Are you a commentator?
No.
Well, I guess really, not really so. Soupy.
Well, would you be seen on a daily news program?
No.
Not strictly that. Soupy, Melba.
Soupy?
I'm sorry, Melba.
I've been taken for you quite a lot.
You've been taken. It's not, could we call this a variety show? I mean, is that the category?
You mean musical variety?
No.
Yes, you did, didn't you?
Yes, that's what I meant.
No.
That's a no. Gene.
Well, the thing you do in television, is it produced under the jurisdiction of a news department versus the entertainment or program department?
Yes.
Arlene.
You know who it is, don't you?
Yeah, I know who it is.
Should we say it together?
Yes, it is.
Hugh Downs.
It is.
You know, I knew that Arlene would spot my voice. Yes, that's why I didn't use any. But.
I can also spot your whisper, no matter what anybody thinks.
Uh-oh, what does that mean?
What does that mean?
Yes, yes, yes.
What's retirement like, Hugh? I don't know anyone else your age that's retired.
Well, you know, all I retired from was 5 a week and getting up at 4:30 in the morning, which after 9 years, I never got used to it, so I knew I wouldn't. And that's
no one ever gets used to it.
Apparently
I did
it
for
not.
6 years myself.
You know.
9 years, whatever.
Yeah.
What would you do?
Well, actually, there are now about 30 projects. Hopefully, many of these things will evaporate by themselves, and some may come to fruition, but I'm keeping everything as loose as possible to give myself a little breather and not allow some kind of a Murphy's Law to overtake me where I wind up busier than I was before.
Are you going to headquarter in Arizona as you
had
planned to, that beautiful house out there?
Yes.
Yeah.
Well, Hugh, of the years you were on the Today Show, any one or two things that
you know, are really great moments to you and will live with you forever?
Yeah, I think so. Among the most rewarding, I think, are interviewing heads of state. You know, that I've interviewed two kings, and hobnobbing with kings is a big deal. And Golda Meir of Israel, and never talked to Queen Elizabeth. She never talked to me, now that I think of it.
Well, maybe that'll work out now, you know. Something I understand she likes Arizona. At least Princess Margaret did.
That's half the battle.
But Hugh, it's great to see you, and keep doing things on television, because we miss you.
Good to be here, and good to see this group again, too. Yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Hugh Downs.
Thank you.
Watch My Line will continue right after this week. Well, good group, that sort of wraps up another session, doesn't it?
Yeah.
You're all available tomorrow,
I think? We're coming back. Yeah, we had a good time.
And I hope you can join us, too, on What's My Line.
Prizes or product mentions were furnished and or paid for by the manufacturers or supplier of the products or services identified on this program. This is Johnny Olson speaking for What's My Line.